Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to the stream. I am going to continue what I worked on last time I streamed, and that is this background that I this background that I started working on from scratch last time I streamed. That was Friday. Did a lot of work on it. As you can see, this is 3 hours work of 3 hours worth of work, so it's pretty good. A little bit pissed off because I just got a ticket and I have to go dispute it tonight in like 2 hours. So stream's gonna be just a little bit shorter because of that. So let's get to work. Where were we? Oh yeah, so I modified this bell here because the angle wasn't right. Angle wasn't right, so just change this a little bit. It's gonna need a bit more work because you know when you see a circle in perspective, it's one of the basic things that you learn when you start drawing shapes and stuff. It's the circle's never supposed to have any kind of angles, no matter what, like angles as in this, you know. It's always got to be like a continuous curve. So this is something that I'm going to have to work on a bit later, but for now, I don't want to worry too much. Sorry. I don't want to worry too much about it. Sorry. Just, I had to run and talk to the cop who just fined me, and I had to run back because I knew that I had to do a stream. So, not a good day for science. So far, not an excellent day for science, but we're gonna power through either way. So, right now, it's just, as you can see, I have this very loose brushing going on here, and I'm gonna keep adding details and try and organize everything so that it doesn't look as loose as possible, right? I can also show you real quick couple other backgrounds that I've worked on this yesterday and during the weekend. Worked on this one, pretty happy with it. Don't want to show too much of it because I don't want to spoil it for you guys, but I'm pretty happy with how it's coming out. And and also did this one real quick yesterday night. Happy with the, I like the color scheme, really love the color scheme, can't wait to work on it some more. But this one I'm gonna work on at home. I now that I can work from home, I'm splitting my work up into home and office work. So this is home work, but I just brought it to the office just to see how it looks like on my setup here, because you know that's always, hey Zernot, what's up? The hair, why am I even wearing these headphones when I'm not listening to anything? I was too lazy to do anything to my hair today, so it's loose. It is loose today. Everything is loosey-goosey today. So, in fact, actually, I forgot that I can listen to music and you guys don't have to, so I'm gonna do exactly that and play some music that you're not gonna be able to listen to. All right, so let's get back to the blue one here. And start defining and refining it just a little bit more. Yeah, I'm really pissed off because I wanted to just stay at work just a bit longer today, just so that I could get a bit more done. And now I have to go dispute a parking ticket, because that's a fun way to spend your evening. So yeah. It's a very limited palette. Here, which is both fun, easy, and well, it's both easy and a little bit complicated. I mean, it's easy because you don't have to worry about a little bit easier because you don't have to worry about thinking up other colors. You know, I got my palette here, and I'm sticking to it. But at the same time, you have to make these colors as efficient as possible. So that's a challenge right there. You know, but I'm enjoying that. Sorry. You notice during these streams, during the beginning of the stream, I'm a little bit quieter. And that's because there's people still working right underneath us, because we're in the attic, and there's people working underneath us. And as they start to phase out and go home, I'm getting louder and louder. So, in case you were wondering, that's the explanation. Oh, I think the sketch wasn't done either for this one, so. Yes, I'm gonna have to work. I'm gonna have to refine the sketch a little bit more too. But I like that I can work in parallel, you know. Like, I'm working on color even though the sketch isn't done. It just feels a little bit more dynamic and stuff. And as usual, I forgot to plug the fact that I'm streaming on social media, so please bear with me while I tweet this out. And I'm gonna go just like this real quick. Now, live streaming background art on, and slap a couple of hashtags there. Game art. Oh man, game art. Point and click. Cthulhu Lovecraft. There we go. And tweeted that out. Let's get back to work. I'm happy with the way backgrounds are progressing lately. I've really started making everything feel a lot more efficient when I'm working, you know. So the pace has picked up quite a bit, and I'm happy about that, because, you know, when you have so many backgrounds to work on, it's a little bit stressful. Just a little bit stressful, especially in a small team, but things are going good. I am delivering them at a very nice steady pace, so happy with that. Just a little bit agitated because the ticket pissed me off, because I had wanted to park farther away from where I parked, somewhere where it was legal and you could do so, and there were absolutely no parking spaces whatsoever. And today of all days, when I did park where I wasn't supposed to either, even though that's debatable, I did get a ticket, and it's messed up because theoretically, you know, right now in town, you don't have to pay to park in the places where you were supposed to pay before. Oh man, I'm not making any sense. It's completely irrelevant. Let's not worry about it. I don't have to tire you with this bullshit. Let's just do some nice art here. I was rambling there, sorry. There we go. I got this adjustment layer here. Usually my adjustment layer brightens things up because I'm on a Cintiq and Cintiq's dark and everything. But in this case, I'm using the exact opposite. I'm using like an adjustment layer to darken stuff because you know, I had picked the color palette, like the color theme. I really enjoyed it, but as I'm working with it, it's nice, but it's a little bit light. So for the final look of this, I'm gonna use this adjustment layer, probably tweak it like a lot, because it needs to be darker. I really want to convey that feeling of a very tiny lit space. This one, you know, when it's like a sea of cold blue darkness. So that's what I'm going for there. Play some music here that you're not gonna be able to hear, hopefully, so that you can make out what I'm saying. Alright. Figure maybe that makes a little bit more sense, because maybe you're listening to your own music and if you have my stream on with sound, it becomes cacophony, so maybe it's better that way. Although you are missing out on some great music, if I do say so myself. What the hell? Some weird shit going on here. Wait a minute, what's going on here? Why can't I? What in darnation? Or tarnation, is it? Why can't I cover that thing? Oh well. Well, I do have these two layers. I do have these two separate layers. For no good reason whatsoever, so let's just merge these layers and see if that solved our problem. And it didn't. I have no idea what's going on here. I have no idea why I can't. Oh, there we go. That solved the problem. I have no idea why that was happening, but now it's not happening anymore, so just move on. Alrighty. And I'm gonna paint just a little bit more, and then I'll go back to the sketch and add some more details where I feel it's necessary. You know, at this point, since it's all hues of blue, it's almost like only working with values. So this one. Oh yeah, see, my sketch is incomplete here, but it's not a problem, because right now I'm just filling in big areas, like blocking out big areas here, just so that it feels a bit more clean, you know. I love the painterly look, but you also need to organize it, and always contrast the painterly stuff with very sharp, well-delimited stuff, like in this case here. It just looks better. And this is not exactly the brush to do that with. But let's not worry about that. Mr. Disciple, what's up? I'm not emo, man. It's just, this is like a compromise sort of hairstyle, cause I miss having long hair like I did when I was a kid in high school, and at the same time I don't like it when my hair, I don't like hair in, on this side of the, of, you know, hair growing over my ears. I do not like that. So with the risk of looking like a fucking hipster, like everyone else looks now, I am sporting this hairdo, and I don't really give a shit, because I'm not 16 anymore. People can say whatever the heck they want. I didn't mean you, I meant generally. It's lazy style, exactly. You know, it's damn hard trying to you know, to tie your hair up in a bun or something every morning and have it look nice and even. It's harder than you'd think, believe me. So I have these days where I'm lazy. And the one day when I was lazy and I didn't do anything to my hair, I get a parking ticket. Coincidence? I don't know. So see, laziness does not pay. I realize that I'm listening to music and humming and you can't hear it, so this might sound really stupid, but it's been a stupid day, so might as well own up to it. Exactly. Exactly. No such thing as a coincidence. Okay. So getting a lot of these backgrounds done. But soon I'm gonna go, I'm gonna start working on character animations again, because I had put that on hold for a while, because I knew that these took a while, you know, the backgrounds took a while, and I wanted to prioritize, but now I feel it's safe to go back to character animation too, so maybe I will do a stream of that soon, although streams like that are a little bit tricky, because, I don't know, animation is weird to stream because it's a much slower process and doesn't really have an immediate reward, just like painting does. But, you know, what the hell. For the sake of variety, probably do that. Kami's animating right now. There she is, working on a... Yeah, not now. Or can I... Oh, okay. Well, yeah, they can't really see it because it's too far away. But it looks good.
And I have the other one too.
Cool. It's good to have Kami doing animations too, because it frees me up a little bit. Yeah, so in case you're curious about the other stream, like the previous stream where I started doing this, it's all on our YouTube channel, and I also put it on Facebook, and on the YouTube channel you can see both the sped up version of it and the full VOD, the 3 hours worth. So In case you're wondering how this all started out, you can see that on our YouTube channel. Thank you, Kami. Go a bit more into detail here. Twitch added this weird communities thing, and I have no idea why I'm doing it, if I'm doing it right. Because it's sort of like the hashtag thing, but you don't need to add a hashtag. You just choose like a community. I don't know why it's just one community. I have no idea, but I chose indie development. And I don't know if it's working. Oh, it is working. So it says I'm streaming in the indie developers community. I don't know what that does. I mean, it looks like I'm the only one. Really? Looks like I'm the only one streaming in the indie developers community. Oh well. That's good, I guess. So, let's go back to painting this nice background here. I wanted to announce the stream on our blog, but the whole ticket thing caught me unaware, so it's not happening. It didn't happen. That's where the bell is. That's why there's an empty space there, in case you were wondering. It's obscured by the bell. Not saved by the bell, obscured by the bell. Chains, always popular with creepy locations. Crap. Just trying to put some order into this chaos here, because Painterly is nice and dandy, fine and dandy, as you say, but you need to organize your brushwork too, you know. Yeah, it's also the light in here is really dim and stuff, and I have this white light from my second monitor hit me right in the face, and I think I bumped up the the contrast on the webcam a little bit, because I'm a contrast whore. I'm all about contrast. Maybe it's apparent in the game too. I really like contrast and stuff. And I also do have these nice bags under my eyes. And I just might be a vampire. I do seem to function better in the evening, at least professionally. I try and do my more important work late afternoon. It's gotta be fast 2 p.m. for me to do really important stuff. I mean, I am productive during the morning too, just not as much. That too. I was, but I was really in love with that background. See, I started this background here. I showed it just a little bit earlier in the stream. Started this background yesterday at 10 p.m. So, no, 10:30, I think. I think I worked on it for a couple of hours. And I really got a lot done. As you can see. So, I'm just gonna stop working because it's so much fun now that I have a Cintiq at home. I'm not gonna work on it right now because this is one for home, you know. I always have to rename them according to the date that I worked on them, because when you have the same thing on two different computers, you can easily mess up and you know, use an outdated file or something like that. And that's what we're trying to avoid that. So that's for home right there. But yeah, I was up working late yesterday night, hence the bags under the eyes. Also got a new computer at home, and it's a lot faster than my previous one, so really motivates me to work, to do more work. Because when it takes like a couple of minutes for Photoshop to start on your computer, it's not as conducive to productivity, you know. It doesn't really make you want to go out of your way to do work. I'm just going to paint for just a little bit more, and then we're going to move on to the sketch. Let's check this out without a sketch. It's still very loose and stuff. It's very, very loose. I'm using this, it's also because I'm using this brush, and it doesn't use, as you can see here, it doesn't use the pressure sensitivity. Because you know, you cover a lot more ground like that. And also it looks a bit more, I mean, it feels a bit more like an actual real brush. So, but you can't really do fine details with it. So, as you can see, everything looks just a little bit not sharp. But that's not a problem. I'm gonna eventually get my marker brush and work on those fine details with it. As like so. I was mentally debating now whether to keep everything monochromatic, you know, do everything in shades and hues of blue, or add a little bit of color, you know, like to these books, for example, which is what I would normally do, because I just love color. But I think this background might benefit from being monochromatic, so I think I'm gonna keep it monochromatic. And just do different hues of blue. So we'll see how that works out. To be honest, I can't stop thinking about how much I dread going to dispute the fucking parking ticket, because I hate going into public institutions and stuff. It's just they are super depressive. Both depressive and oppressive, so I really dread doing that. I could not be a public servant. couldn't be a private servant either. I guess I couldn't be a servant. Period. I'm just rambling here. And I've also had way too much coffee, and I was about to have another one, but I caught myself, so it's kind of overdoing the caffeine thing lately. Hey, Michael, what is up? Fucking hair getting in the way. It's all happening because I didn't. I was too lazy to tie my hair up this morning. How do you say that? Tie your hair up? I have no idea. I don't know how you say that. Oh boy, I'm really agitated. And we can turn that into a positive thing, because as you can see, I'm working really, really hard. Really, yeah, hard too, but fast. Yeah, I'm working really fast here, so. My hair keeps getting into my mouth. Ah, brother. But we shall press on. And as I said, I just made the decision. I just took the decision of keeping stuff monochromatic. So that way I don't have to worry about what colors to mix into this background. Everything's gonna be shades of blue. And I'm gonna stick to my palette here. Pretty little palette here, so. That's how we are rolling today, ladies and gentlemen. That is how we are rolling. So, I'll just paint these books here in. And then I'm gonna switch over to working on the sketch just a little bit. Just referencing my palette there. Anthony Kiedis? Oh, dude, I wish I looked as good as. I mean, I wish when I'm 50 or however old he is, I look that good. Cause that dude is that dude is a vampire. Now that's a vampire right there. Kami's a big fan of the Red Hot Chili Peppers. Or was, at least. I just said that you're a big fan of the Red Hot Chili Peppers. And you saw them live in concert. And it was horrible. Because it sounded bad. Well, you know. See, slowly adding detail. Slowly, I mean, it's slowly starting to come together. Even without the sketch layer, it'll take a little bit. You know, to be completely honest, I kind of overcomplicated this background compared to what I had envisioned it to be, but I just can't, I admit I can't really help myself, so I just, you know, if I have a feeling that I can do this, that I can make it a bit more interesting, even if it's not the wisest thing to do, I'm just gonna do it. Because I guess that's what you get when you have an artist as your project lead. Things like this are probably inevitable. Well, I mean, it's for the good of the game, ultimately. It benefits the game and the player. You know, I constantly get this feeling that this is a once, and it is probably a once in a lifetime opportunity to prove ourselves and make an awesome game. So that's why making compromises, especially visually, but not just visually, it's just very hard for me, and I would rather not do it. I would rather not do it. All right, let's do some more let's add some more to the sketch here, because I feel we need to do that. We can hide the palette here. And where were we? Oh yeah, I think we were over here, adding more details. Yes, absolutely. And it's just some, I hate it when that happens. Some pyramids of weird dust, which may or may not be explained in the game. And another cupboard door. Over here. Again, see, I got this line. This line tells me where the screen ends on top. So this is as much as the player sees normally. So the screen's not gonna scroll vertically unless you. I mean, it will only probably only scroll vertically like twice or something. So I don't really have to worry as much about this, because this is gonna be something that you catch with the corner of your eye as the screen scrolls up. So it's gonna go, you know, you're gonna be in the screen here. Let's see where Don is. Here's Donnie. And then we're gonna have this nice scroll up. Probably the speed's gonna be something like this. And then we're gonna get a glimpse of the bell. And then we're gonna pan back down, scroll back down, that is. So, as I said before, don't have to worry too much about the details above the green-blue line, if that makes sense. So let's worry about the rest now. Let's worry about what's underneath the line, because you're gonna be staring at that, so. So I want to make that interesting for you, because I'm just that nice a guy. Lots of bags in this background. I really want to answer why. Oh, I remember that I said I wanted to do a little bit of research for this lamp here. And I will do that. First, I'm going to add some more paraphernalia around here. And something that I'm going to be adding a lot to this background are these feathers. And there's a reason for that in-game, which I will not disclose right now. You know, drawing feathers in a cartoony manner is kind of tricky, because they can always end up looking like long leaves. So that's a problem that you might have when you make a cartoony adventure game. Just so you know. And I would love for some of these leaves to be blown by the wind here and there. I think that's possible. I have to talk to Nico about that. It'd be a really nice touch, you know, just to have like a little bit of draft blowing leaves back and forth. But it's got to be really subtle. So we're going to discuss that. Unfortunately, Nico's not in today because he's feeling a little bit sick. So, but yesterday we worked on this scene. This is a really cool scene from close to the beginning of the game. Actually, it's the first scene that you play after you finish what's in the demo. And man, it came out so nicely. It was just so awesome. I was giddy yesterday. I was really giddy. Just I just love the way it turned out. It was just great. Alright, let's make a folder here. Move all the DAWNs to it. Let's call it DAWNs. So yeah, it just feels so good, you know, after having worked on these backgrounds for so long. Just feels so good seeing them come together into a game and seeing all the animations, you know, playing inside them and all the real-time light effects and stuff. And just, you know, just it's becoming a game. It's becoming an actual game, and it's very exciting. It's a very, very exciting feeling. Can't wait to get a chance to work on music some more and record voices and everything. It's just super exciting, super, super exciting. Now, I think working on games is one of the most satisfying things you can do creatively, because, I mean, you see your drawings come to life, literally. So it's, what the hell more can you ask for as an artist? I think it's a great, great, great feeling. And it's super, it's a very cool motivation, because especially when you have these very elaborate, detailed pieces of background, which you have to spend hours and hours on, because, you know, you have that motivation that this is not going to be just a static art piece. This is going to be the piece of the world where your character is going to be able to move around and explore and stuff. And it's just great motivation to put in those hundreds of hours. Well, eventually it's probably going to be it is already thousands of hours. And I think that's one of the reasons that you don't burn out so easily, because you get to see your stuff in game, and it's just beautiful. So I just love that feeling. I always love to add a little bit of, like, a couple of nails here and there. They just look nice. They break up the shapes nicely. You know, it's not a safe thing to have, you know, just nails jutting out of your furniture, but they look good. Just adding feathers here. Lots of feathers. Oh, so yeah, I don't remember who it was on the forums and stuff, but they suggested using Discord for like a team chat, I think it is. I don't even exactly know what Discord is, but I guess it's a good way to keep up with people that are interested in the game. So I made this Discord server, I guess, and I can just paste the, just a sec, I forgot how to do that. Completely forgot how to do that. Streamer mode is enabled. Alright. So how do I do this? Welcome to your server. Share button. Oh. Use copy button. There we go. Alright. So, if you do this Discord thing, this is our channel. I don't really know what this is good for or what it does, but we have a Discord. So if you want to join that, feel free. I guess it's for chatting. Or, I don't know, sharing links? I have no idea. But, you know, if you're interested in Giblis, you can just join there, I guess. And I guess we'll chat? I don't know. I haven't really looked into it, that's the thing. I know that people are using it, so I guess we're using it too now. It was suggested. And we're doing it. Was it you, Michael? I don't remember who suggested Discord. Oh, cool. Okay. All right. So, we can do that. Because to be honest, Facebook is nice, but when I post on it, it doesn't, like, the post doesn't, if you don't have a paid account or something, it doesn't really reach everyone, and it can very easily just get lost in the clutter that is your Facebook feed. And Twitter is nice, but I always forget to use it, and I think I'm following a lot of people who I don't know why I'm following, so. Excuse me while I change the music here, because it's not good. There we go. Adding details, you know, stuff that people won't even give a second look to, but I know I like having this. Skulls are always nice. Skulls are always nice. Who knows what's in these bags? Well, I do, but I'm not saying. I'm not telling. Cool. I don't know. We mainly use Skype, but it's not that great. I mean, it's all right. There we go. Oh, brother. All right, let's add some more details to this. Oh, sorry. What happened there? Add some more details to these books here. Me. All right. Hey, it works. All right. So that's our Discord. If you want to join, I know we can share funny cat videos and stuff like that. I'm always down for that. Talk about the game. Talk about games in general. Whatever the hell you guys want. Hope it's not gonna completely ruin my productivity. Coolio. Just adding details to these books. Just, you know, nice to have details. Yes, a Discord, and you are welcome to join it. Ayo. So, it was just me not using Discord? That's weird. I guess I am really behind the times. Because I don't really know what it is, what it's good for. But I guess we will find out. Because I guess I'll be using it from now on. I guess we all will. Alright. Lots of triangles in this game. Lots of them. Because, you know, they're popular. Oh, man. You can use it in the future to announce them. Oh, yeah, right. You're right. That's a very good idea, man. So it is useful. All right. Coolio. All right, let's see what we got so far. Skulls. Skulls are nice. Okay, got a decent amount of detail added in. I think we can go back to painting. Got a decent amount of sketch here. Coolio. Yeah, I noticed it said streamer mode. I have no idea why that says. It says stay safe, friend, which is nice. Cool. We will use that. I don't even know how to change my avatar. Oh, now I know. Oh, okay. I just had to click that. Streamer mode enabled. All right. Nice. Thank you, Michael. Right-click user for more actions. Profile. How do I change my picture? I have no idea. Doesn't matter. We're streaming. Find that out later. I will find that out later. Alright. Oh, the lamp. I want a particular type of lamp. And I have to... no, not this. Sorry about that. Oh. Yeah, this is it. That's the one. All right, let's get a reference up in here. There's our, oh, that's a huge reference. I want to stay completely, you know, I don't want to copy it, like use the reference exactly, but who's writing on it? Cool, let's do this. Nice. Let's sketch this baby. I'm gonna do like a very rough sketch first. On this layer, right. I mean, it wasn't that important, but hey, you know. Want it to be a little bit Want it to be believable, I guess. You can use the web version on the OS app or even download the phone app. Oh, cool. There's a very cool hidden, well, it's not a hidden object game. It's a hidden character game that just came out and it looks really awesome. But I know I'm not going to have time to play it. It's called Hidden Folks. Let me just link that up for you guys. Cause I don't know, it looks like a lot of fun. Looks like a lot of fun. And if you have OCD, it's going to literally kill you. There it is. Check it out. It's funny. It's a really funny, yeah. That's a really funny and fun trailer. I love it. And I think it's been doing, I think it's doing nicely on Steam. Just at least according to Steam Spy. Oh, and speaking of Steam Spy, if you're interested in the whole new Steam Direct thing, Total Biscuit has a nice roundtable video about it. And it includes the guy who owns Steam Spy, Sergey something. I don't remember what his name is, but I'm actively directing you away from the stream by posting these links, but you can watch them later, I guess. Cool, we have our lamp too. So let's just get rid of this reference like it never happened. Just pretend it never happened. I don't use references. I just know how to draw everything from my imagination and my extensive memory. Right. All right. I'm talking bollocks here, as Jim Sterling would say. Yeah, it's a 2-hour video. I mean, I like it. The longer the better for me. Because, you know, I'm interested in everything, indie games and everything. So, I'm always on the lookout for stuff to listen to while I clean up or work out or something similar. So, the longer the better for me. And of course, entertaining, hopefully. Ideally entertaining, too. But yeah, Steam Direct is going to be a big deal, and I'm really curious what it's going to cost for people to get on Steam, because I think we got away really, really cheaply with $100, because if it's going to be like $2,000-$3,000, it's going to be really, it's going to really suck for the small indies. Because if we have to go to our producer and ask for $2,000 just to get on Steam, it's a tough sell. Especially for Romania, you know, it's a lot of money. It's a lot of money. It's not like a Western country where that's one month's salary. It's a lot. That's what she said. Oh, you couldn't help yourself, could you? All right. Let's see what we got here so far without the sketch. It's a little bit better. Guys, you know, I'm going to be completely honest with you. Not only am I tired, but I also got, the whole ticket thing pissed me off, and I've had too much caffeine, so today's not going to be as productive and effective as other streams, but if you bear with me, I'm gonna do my best here. I am going to do my best. Well, luckily I was productive before, you know, during the day, got a lot done on that other background that I've showed you. So that's good. That I've shown you. Sorry, I can't even get my grammar straight today. Cannot even get my grammar straight. So I'm just messing around here just a little bit before I move on to detail stuff. Sorry about that. This Windows 10 always protests something. You know, it's always complaining. No idea why. Where's my palette at? There we go. Alright, let's really go into detail here. My grandma with an R at the end. And as I said before, I'm keeping it monochromatic, because that's the new in thing. Only using this pinkish hue here because we got this whole lit from below situation. But I really enjoy this part of rendering, where I go in and just put everything into place, you know. Everything that was very painterly and stuff, I just neatly cut and rearrange, and you know, just get the shapes to look, you know, look everything, make everything look sharper. It's fun. And look at this shit. This does not make any sense. I don't know what I was thinking when I drew this. This, let me just highlight that for you. This cannot continue into this. Can you see? See what I did there? That was really dumb. Really dumb of me. This is how it was supposed to be. Because that's the bottom. This is the bottom. But, you know, stuff like that happens. Let me just undo what I drew here. Right. And correct the sketch here. There we go. Oh man, I'm sorry, Michael. I don't want to bring your productivity down. But oh man, what the hell? Oh, okay. I don't stream that often though, so I wanted to stream more often, but I always get caught up in different stuff, and that's why it's, I know I've been saying that I'm gonna stick to a schedule and stuff, but it's hard. It is hard. Mr. Disciple, you are a silly man. And that's why we like having you around. Yeah, I'm not a morning person either. Although I'm the kind of person that's gonna, you know, walk around the house singing and everything. Just, that's not because I'm excited that it's morning. It's because I'm trying to get myself motivated to do stuff. Because moping doesn't really help, I find. It really doesn't. Another thing that I do, and I really shouldn't, is use these. I mean, I sketch. I do the sketch with a brush that's way too thick, and that, you know, unfortunately hides a lot more than it should, and that's why I don't get these nice. That's why it's harder to get these nice sharp edges. But oh man. There's also this weird thing that Photoshop does that, you know, from a certain level of zoom above, it just goes into this weird pixel-like thing, which I guess is nice, but I really have to look into whether I can turn this off or not, because it's a little bit annoying, because I would like to be able to zoom in this much. This is, I don't know what percentage this is, but either way, I would prefer it without the grid. That's right. It's in the back of my mind. Whoa. On Mr. Skull here. Can't go wrong with skulls. That's what I always say. You cannot go wrong with skulls. And I think, though, I should switch to my detail brush for all this, because it's really hard to pull off details with this wide brush, as much as I love it, and I do love it. Can you guys hear any of my music? Just, it doesn't, like, on my monitor, it doesn't seem like on my meter, it doesn't seem like it's supposed to. Oh, waffles. I got some cookies in that cupboard back there. But should I? Oh, no music. All right. What about now? All right, so it's working. It's good to know, because it was working last time. It was working back the last time, but I just wanted to make sure it works right now. In case you're wondering, that's web design that's being discussed down there. Nothing shady, I'm sure. We are being, I mean, Kami's being really quiet right now. Good, 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 good. And the good part is that Twitch is not going to mute parts of my audio, just because there was some kind of song that had some kind of copyright. And at least Twitch only mutes, again, part of my audio. Because if you upload one of these VODs of the streams, and someone files an automatic copyright claim on the music that you played, you never know what you're gonna get. Best case scenario, which happened with one of my latest streams, they just said that the whatever revenue I'm making off the video is going to be to the owner of the track, which is fine because I'm not making any kind of money as far as I know off of these videos. Worst case scenario, they just mute your entire fucking audio, all of it, indiscriminately, which is such a dick move to do. Jesus. YouTube. No. So yeah, YouTube is not nice when it comes to copyright claims and stuff, you know. And I mean, I can understand muting that part of the audio. I don't understand muting an entire 3-hour stream just because one of your copyrighted songs was used for like 5 minutes during it. That's just not reasonable. I'm sorry. It's just not. Yeah, exactly. That's exactly what I'm saying. So at least Twitch is nice about it. And it's fair, you know, it makes sense. Although I would love to know, you know, just submit a playlist or something and just they could just let me know which ones are alright to use and which ones are not. Because that would really be a lot easier for me. It would make it easier for me. And, you know, it's not that much of a big deal. I can just listen to the music and you don't have to be subjected to it either, so maybe it's for the better, for the best. All right, let's move on to the modulated brushy and just really sharpen everything around here. And now I can't stop thinking of those cookies in the cupboard, and I think I'm gonna be a weak man and go for them in like a second. If they're still there, they should be. If they're not, we have a crime on our hands. Something to investigate, but they should be there. Yeah, I know they do, but come on, I want to listen to their non-copyrighted whatever. I mean, I don't want to have to wade through their library and see what I would like to listen to, and I know. First world problems. I'm fully aware that these are not real problems. It's just that I'm really, even if I'm talking through all of this, I'm really used to listening to stuff listening to something when I'm streaming, you know? The manner is required to go through all the uploads every day that are flagged and copyrighted, especially for a free service. Yeah, but no, I think that can be, I hear what you're saying, but I think that can be automated, because Twitch does it automatically. Like, once I'm done with a stream, in like a couple of minutes, it will have already muted the segment of the audio that had a copyright on it, you know? So I'm thinking YouTube should be able to do that too. Again, I'm not monetizing any of this. Like, the idea of these streams and of the VODs are just to share with people, you know, just share the development of the game with people who are interested in it. But I guess, you know, best compromise is I'm the only one listening to the music, you're not bothered by it, we might not have the same musical preferences, and you can also listen to your music while you're watching the stream, so everybody's happy. And I think that's what think that's what we're gonna be doing from now on. Although you're missing out on some great music. Just saying. Just saying. Find that Twitch mutes a flat 30 minutes. It does? I don't know. The truth is that I never really. It might. I don't know. I don't exactly know how much they mute. I know that they do mute portions. I don't think I've ever. I don't think I've ever measured just how much of the song they mute. So. But either way, these things are. I think they're odd. They're definitely automated because they happen like minutes after my stream is done, you know, so. Alright, let's see what we got here. See, you can tell that I've been using the more defined, like the detail brush here, because it's starting to look a bit better. But you can tell, you see here, where the colors don't, they're not tangent. That's because my goddamn sketch is way too. I mean, I use way too big a brush for the sketch, and that's because I have to work really fast because we have a game to make, and we want it to be done this year, not in 2020. So I have to make all these compromises, you know. I mean, they're not real compromises. Well, fuck. I just have to work real fast. That's the idea. And working fast implies, you know, using big also implies using bigger brushes to do the sketches because. Thankfully, I really love, and I've always loved working really fast, like drawing fast, you know. I have friends who are excellent draftsmen, and they work super slow. And I'm glad that I just, you know, I educated myself to just work quickly. Could be better, but it's kind of obvious the big companies tend to. Yes, exactly. Just like Steam. And unfortunately, they are the best example of not wanting to be hands-on with their own product. And on the one hand, I can completely respect that because they have that crazy, crazy way of just, you know, they organize their company in like they have a horizontal structure. So everyone just works on whatever they feel like at the moment. And they have these mobile desks that they just wheel around whenever they feel like working on something else, and that's great. But at the same time, they're the biggest. They're a huge PC game, biggest PC game distributor. They should, I think they should curate their site just a little bit better. Because it's a shame if good games don't, you know. They don't reach the consumer because the system is flooded with shit, basically. But you know, there's always God. So that's good. And GOG do curate their system. Because they can just flat out refuse you. I have no idea whether we're gonna be on GOG or not. I would love for the game to be on GOG, but that's really up to them. Alrighty. Erase. Oh shit, okay. I was working on the. I didn't realize it was the same layer yet again. Alright. What I realized is that this window here must be a lot more, I mean, it must be a lot more affected by the by the light than it is. So we're gonna fix that right now. And yeah, let's add the adjustment layer. I'm gonna call this adjustment layer darkness imprisoning me so that I remember what it does. Usually it's called so you can see what the fuck you're doing, because it's usually the light one. Now I'm using the dark one. I'm using the dark side of the force. What am I even saying here? I'm not having a good day, guys. And I'm not having a great day. But we're pushing through nonetheless. Great opportunity to use exaggerated shadows, because we have a light coming from the bottom, and that's always fun. Kami, do we have any more cookies?
Yes.
May I have a cookie, ma'am? Thank you, ma'am.
Cookies. And
chocolate. And cookie! No, I already ate chocolate today. Can I take 2 cookies?
Please do.
Thank you. You are very generous.
Hi, guys.
There's Kami. They are suffering alongside myself. Good cookie. All right. Keep going. Thank you for the cookie. Oh god. Don't let me choke on the cookie. Oh. Hey, Retalk. Yes, cookies. Unfortunately, they are not homemade. But they're alright. They're alright. They can help me pull through this day, which isn't the best day I've ever had. Because I got a parking ticket. And I don't mind about the money. It's really not the money. I have to go dispute it. And I don't feel like going there. I wanted to spend the evening working on the game some more, not arguing with police officers. But I guess that's how it's gonna be. Alrighty. See, I could always take down lower the opacity on this layer, and it's gonna be helpful, but also at the same time just a little bit more confusing. Alright, let's do it either way. I'm not gonna argue with the cops that bad. I am not a bad boy. I'm not one of those gangster types. I'm just gonna nicely plead for them not to find me, because it's quite a bit of money and I cannot afford that. We did get a... We did get a PayPal donation recently that could cover like 10% of it, but I am not going to embezzle that money. That money goes toward development. It's not going to pay for my ticket. That money is going to go to a couple more voice lines. I just recently talked to a voice actor who does these amazing creepy voices. You would not believe them. And he's agreed to do some voices for Gibbous, and I'm stoked. And when you play the game, you will see why. You will see why. Yeah, so what I was saying was earlier, but I didn't manage to articulate it, is that the street that we work on, you know, it's one of those streets where you can't park without having like without having paid in advance and stuff. But, and I did that all last year. But now, because some bureaucratic thing, no one has to pay anymore for that kind of stuff. So now everybody parks here, because there's also a university nearby. And I get into work a bit late, like 10 or 10, around 10:30, and there are no more parking spaces. And I usually drive a lot farther and park somewhere where I am allowed to. But today, of all days, I did not do that, because even those parking spaces were full. So, and of course, as Murphy's Law would have it, I got a ticket. It's quite a bit of money. The guy said it's the equivalent of $150, something like that. And just, I hope he was fucking with me, because that's not a normal amount to pay for a parking ticket. I really hope so. Now I have to go beg not to get fined, I guess. At 6 p.m., that's 1 hour from now, so this stream is gonna be a short one. I will probably try and make up for that by streaming again, probably Thursday. Same time, same hour. But I'm gonna announce that on Discord, in case I don't forget, so let me just... cool. Let me just... How do I... I did share that above or something. Oh yeah, all right. So in case you missed it, thanks for your talk. In case you missed it, this is our Discord. So if you wanna, I guess, chat, I guess that's what you do with this thing, you can just join. Just not that active right now on it because I'm painting. Oh crap. So that's our Discord. If it's fun and useful, I'm gonna share it in a Kickstarter update, or definitely gonna share it in a blog update. And maybe it'll be an easy way to just quickly share with you guys what else we've been doing on the game, you know. And with your permission, I'm gonna have my second and final cookie. Abu. Oh, cool, thanks. It did ask me that, but I didn't know if I wanted to set the link not to ever expire. How do I do that? Privacy? I don't know. I'll do that later. I promise. I will do that later. A special room for backers. That's a good idea. I mean, yeah, sure. Why not? If I figure out how to do that, I will, I guess. Yeah, I guess it's a good idea, because not everyone is on social media all the time. And And I'll probably share a lot of game dev related links. What's up, Gummy Bunny?
I'm making a cookie. Huh? Put it away. You want another cookie?
I really shouldn't, but yes, thank you.
If I see them, I just
hit my cookie quota for the day. Sorry, sometimes when I listen to songs that I really love, I can't help myself. And I have to sing. So please forgive my audio transgressions. Oh crap. Alright. It expired already. How do I do that? Okay, continue to Discord. What? No. How do I do this? How do I get the link to my own server? Oh yeah, share button. There we go. Copy. Oh, all right. Oh no, I found it. Never mind, guys. Found it. And I just set the link to never expire. So I guess we'll be using this one from now on. So, all right. That's you know it, man. You know it. That's exactly. That's completely true. It's just such a bitch updating everything. But never mind. So this link that I put in the chat right now, I set that one to never expire. So I guess that's what we're using. So let me just save that real quick. All right. I bookmarked that. So feel free to join that one. And I will look into Discord a bit later, but for now, we can all chat and share stuff there. And that's probably gonna happen starting tomorrow for me, because tonight's gonna be a bit crazy, trying to escape the parking ticket and trying to get some work done. So, maybe I'll just install Discord at home too. We'll see. I think I will.
How's it going?
It's going pretty good. You need to join our Discord chat.
Yeah, but you need to tell me.
But you just need to download the.
I don't have a chance.
Now you go download Discord, sign up, and I'll give you a link, and you join in. And then it's gonna be great. Pinterest is awesome though. I love Pinterest. I'm getting a lot of repins. Whatever the fuck that is, I don't know. But I'm getting a lot of them. Repins. People are repinning my stuff. So that's good, I guess. Although I haven't made.
Although it's not you.
It's not me. I mean, it's. It's just stuff I found online. I have a pretty sweet Lovecraft board. If y'all are interested, I am going to plug my board. Oh, plug my Lovecraft board there. Yeah. No, nothing on my phone. I have enough push notifications on that thing. I promise. Way too many. So check out my sweet Lovecraft board, man. It's really good. And if you find cool Lovecraft-related imagery, feel free to share it on our Discord, and I am going to pin it. I'm gonna pin the fuck out of it. I don't know why I am using a lot of profanity today. I'm a bit agitated and pissed off, so I apologize. I hope I don't offend anyone. I also need to pee, damn it. Hate interrupting myself. Yes, you will. Yes, you will. So again, I'm gonna... So that's our permanent Discord link. Just making sure everyone got it. Alrighty. And please don't go anywhere. I need to pee. I'll be right back. And I'm back. Whew. All right. All right, where were we? Adding details to this baby. I think a good idea here would be to color my sketch differently. So this way I can more easily tell what's filled in and what isn't, and where the sketch actually ends and where it begins. So why didn't I do this earlier? Why? See, that's a lot better. I'm glad I had this idea. Usually I color my sketches in blue, because that's what all artists do for some reason that doesn't really have anything to do with digital, but it's just like a tradition. But in this case, since everything's blue, obviously it would be pointless, so. Anthony Kiedis quotes. Oh my God, it's me. Come on. I'm Anthony Kiedis. Let me just show this on stream, because... Oh my God! You know, I was seriously considering shaving my goatee and leaving my mustache, and now I'm even more inclined to do so. But he has no sideburns, so it doesn't add up. I've had sideburns. I think I only shaved my sideburns once when I was 20-something. Well, I didn't really have sideburns all the time. You couldn't really call them sideburns, but I always had what tried to be sideburns. So if it ain't got sideburns, it ain't me. I don't know why I felt the need to share that with you guys. I'm very honest today, I guess. And why did I not do this before? Why? It does look like me, huh? I mean, not physically, but just like the hairdo and stuff. Kami just said that I look just like him in that picture. That's exactly what I said. This is called the lazy rocker hairdo. Or the compromise hairdo, when you wanna be a rebel, but at the same time conform just a little bit, I guess. Am I above? No, I am right. Alright, that works. That works. I was looking forward to getting to this other skull here. Just love painting skulls, I guess. So, cool. I'm kind of excited about the whole Discord thing now. I'm kind of excited. Yeah, especially because, oh man, announcing these streams is just such a pain in the ass, because I always forget. I mean, I announce it in one place and I forget to announce it in another place. So, you know, people who are closer to the development of the game and are more interested and are willing to join a weird Discord chat just to keep up with the game and the streams, I think that's going to be useful. Because it will be more effective. That's good. Though when I keep my head like this, you're not going to be able, you can't see my face anymore, so not that that's important. Getting missing important facial reactions from myself when I messed up, like, wasn't supposed to do that. Yeah, see, that's better. That is a lot better. And I want to congratulate myself for having this idea of coloring my sketch purple. It was a great thought, and I'm glad I had it. That sounds nice, but the question is, am I technically literate enough to know how to program that bot? Or do you have to I mean, I suppose you have to, like, set it up. So, yet another thing that I need to study. Man, this whole making an indie game thing is a lot more work than you would initially think. Especially the whole PR and so-called PR and so-called marketing. So many things to catch to stay up to date with, you know. And I thought that the Kickstarter campaign was gonna be the hardest thing to do, and it kind of was. But at the same time, it was concentrated. It was relatively short amount of time, but at the same time, you know, this just keeping people in the loop. Also taking a lot of time and effort. Tell me what to type and I will do it. Cause it'd be nice to have a bot that automatically posted to the Discord whenever our account was one of our accounts was streaming. What was the most stressful month? Nah, it was definitely the Kickstarter. It was definitely the Kickstarter because, especially that trial in the middle that I guess no one escapes. We knew it was coming, but the trial is the period of time during the Kickstarter, somewhere in the middle where donations start to fall, you know. They don't come in as often as they did before, and that's completely normal, and it happens to like 99% of the campaigns. But at the same time, you know, I was aware of that, but we did get a lot. We did really get carried away with how well the campaign was going initially. Like, especially like the first few hours, we were almost in tears with happiness because we did not expect to have so many donations pouring in. It was just great. So the trial was just a bit scary, and at a point there, although we knew that chances were very slim, we even thought that we would not be funded, right, Kami?
Yep.
So that was the most stressful, you know. But at the same time, that was the most stressful period during the Kickstarter. And at the same time, you know, you get a little bit after you do the Kickstarter, you get a little bit of maybe like a little bit of withdrawal, like you kind of need that, you kind of miss that sort of excitement. But at the same time, I don't know how long I could have done that for, because it really takes a toll on you. And this from the perspective of someone with a successful Kickstarter campaign. I cannot imagine what it's like to do one that's not successful. And there have been great, great fucking games who didn't. Like, they didn't make their goal initially, and they had to do another campaign, and that's gotta be... Like, Dropsy, for example, which I understand is a great great adventure game. I own. I haven't really played it, but I know people really love it. Jay had a campaign initially that failed, and then he had a successful one, and ultimately the game was a huge success. So, but yeah, definitely the Kickstarter. Kickstarter period, that was super stressful, and not just stressful because we were worrying, but also I have never ever sent so many emails as I did during the campaign in my entire life, and most of them, like 99% of them, just fell on deaf ears, because that's the sad reality. If people don't know anything about you, they're not gonna give a shit about you. And also we contacted a lot of, we did some stupid things too. We contacted a lot of YouTubers. And instead of going through their about tab and finding their Gmail or whatever, their emails, and contacting them via email, we contacted a lot of them via direct message. And to this day, you know, almost 1 year later, I still get private messages from YouTubers going, "Oh my God, the game looks so great. I'm so sorry. your message went straight to my spam, and I had no idea. And you know, you guys want me to feature your demo and stuff, and we would, but the demo is kind of obsolete now. We really should update that demo. But anyway, I'm rambling here. You know, just sending. I remember it was one weekend. I sent 300 plus emails during one weekend, and they weren't really. I mean, they had some copy paste information in it. You know, like the description of the game and la 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 and all of that, the links. But also, I personalized each and every one of those emails. You know, and just not just changing the name of the person that I was addressing the email to, but also just, you know, just saying something about them. And I don't know, I just did a lot of crazy fucking work, and most of it for naught. Because it was kind of frustrating, especially just, you know, I mean, it's hard to be objective about your own game, but I did know that we had a pretty good demo going, and the game looked pretty enough and looked good enough and stuff. But I guess, I don't know, I just guess, I think it was like a Kickstarter thing, not a Lovecraft thing. I think it was a Kickstarter thing. People just didn't want to write about Kickstarters. And when there were very few games that these big sites write about, and I have no idea what the criteria is, because some of them I can understand why they would write about them, because they were either had like a quirky idea or were very good looking, but they also, I don't know, they also featured and they keep featuring some Kickstarter projects that are just not that, but I guess that's subjective. Either way, it was a little bit frustrating, you know. And at some point I never mentioned that there was a Kickstarter involved until the last paragraph of the emails. So those were some crazy times. But at the same time, I think it was the best and most exciting month of my life. It was just great. Even though everything was virtual, you know, there weren't people, I mean, everything was virtual. It was about people on the internet, but it was just such a great outpour of, I don't know if I would call it love. Maybe it's a bit too much to say love, but it was just appreciation for what we had done. It was just amazing.
Yeah. But at the end, we were so tired. I myself couldn't even be happy for the Kickstarter, because I was so exhausted.
And the thing is that
I couldn't feel anything anymore. I was just so.
And we didn't take a break. I think we took like a couple of days off. Maybe not. Did we take a couple of days off?
No, not right after. I think
not
after
right.
About 2 weeks.
Yeah,
Disciple.
We just started working on the game directly.
Yeah.
And it was weird because the realization that the Kickstarter was successful didn't really sink in until like months later.
I think
we were like, have we really done that Kickstarter?
We were just tired and couldn't believe it.
Did we really get $56,000?
Yeah.
Well, yeah. And yes, I know that the most stressful times are yet to come, because that's, you know, as much as I hate the idea of crunch, that's definitely, I mean, that's probably going to be a thing, because look, we're definitely not going to be able to release the game in May like the Kickstarter said, because that was a very rough estimate. But we're not going to rest until the game is done.
Never.
I'm really working really hard. It's. I mean, all this effort is going to be worth it. I just hope we don't burn out or anything. And it sucks because there's all sorts of delays that you can't really account for, like Nico being sick now. He's been having some bad days and weeks lately, and he keeps writing me on Facebook and saying, "Man, I'm so sad that I'm letting you guys down, but I feel so sick and I can't even make it to work." And I'm like, "Dude, don't worry about it. Worry about your health first. Forget the game. Just worry about being healthy first." So yeah, the stressful part is yet to come. But that's why, you know, that's why I'm trying to mitigate that by getting as much work done now as possible, you know. because everybody asks us where when we're gonna release the game. It's very hard to tell because it's not, you know, it's very hard to estimate even the part that depends on us, let alone, you know, voices and recording music and translating and all that kind of stuff. And we don't really wanna do early access and stuff like that. It doesn't really make sense for a story game, and yeah, we just need to get the game done completely and release it. That's Mr. Kami, it's Mr. Disciple, it's not just Mr. Yeah. Yeah, update the demo. I would love to update the demo. And I would also love to, you know, the demo is not exactly the beginning of the game. There's like an intro. It's like a relatively lengthy part of the game before the demo happens. And what I was thinking was, update the demo with that initial part too, which doesn't really spoil stuff because it sort of sets up the premise, which we already are seeing, you know, that Kid A starts talking and stuff. So depending on how things go, that might be an idea. That would be a pretty substantial chunk of game if we updated the demo and made it. I don't know if we're gonna make it publicly available though. I'm still not sure. We have to consider these things, you know, we really have to take that into consideration. But we'll see. Maybe just share the updated demo with the backers. I guess, I don't know. But yeah, we can't, all these decisions are pretty hard to make because we don't have the luxury of just taking a little bit of time and just thinking about stuff and just taking a couple of days to think about what would be better to do. And it's just work all the time, just turning out art and refining puzzles and everything. I'm telling you guys, if you ever want to go full indie, and I know that there's at least one person in this room that either has already or is going to go full indie, man, expect not to have any kind of life. That's everything that you'll be doing. Everything. Like, the one compromise that I do make for the sake of my health is go to, you know, work out every day. I try to work out every day. Not for, you know, for health reasons, basically. Because you sit in this fucking chair for so many hours. That's worse for you than smoking is. So the one thing that I do keep up with is just trying to move a little bit, you know, and during the evenings. But other than that, and maybe watching an episode of a show or something, maybe getting to play maybe 30 minutes or an hour of a game, or maybe 2 hours if I stay up real late. Other than that, it's just work. Just an FYI. I mean, of course, it's common knowledge, but I'm just confirming it. It's crazy. It's really crazy. Just tell them the release date was for the updated demo. Oh, man. But the truth is that I didn't really know what to set as a tentative release date, because how the fuck do you do that? This is our first game, and we're not ashamed to say it. It's our first game. It's our first game, and you know, it's hard enough to estimate something that might take you, I don't know, months, but like an entire game. And the thing is that when we did the Kickstarter, I had an idea of the general plot outlines and everything, but I didn't know what the game was going to be, because, you know, it didn't make any sense just to make an entire game design document and think up puzzles and plot and everything. And if the Kickstarter wasn't successful, that would have been for naught, and I would have been very depressed and stuff. So I only thought of and designed the demo, And I had a pretty general idea what came before and after. But how the hell do you estimate how much that would take? And, you know, retrospectively, I should have set a much later date, tentative release date, probably like October 2017 or November or whatever. But at the same time, you know, I didn't know. I just thought 1 year is a nice round, you know, period of time. And I definitely knew that I didn't want us to go upward too much. Like, didn't want us to go 2 years or something like that. But it's not, you know, we are doing everything in our power to release as early as possible. And it's going to be 2017, definitely. I mean, at least, yeah, everything that depends on us, that's, we're doing our best, 21st century. Yeah, but I don't know if that's, I don't know how much of a problem that release date is, because at least for me with Kickstarters, for me it's sort of a fire and forget deal, because I like this project, I want it to happen, I want to support those people, I back them, and then I only remember that project existed when they publish an update or something. I mean, of course, I mean, but okay, in my case, it's a bit different because I'm maybe a bit busier than your average person, because I'm working on this game, so. Yeah, but you know, it wasn't disingenuous on our part, the estimate. We might have been super wrong with it, but we really had no idea what to put there, and 1 year seemed like, I don't know. That's the release date. Yeah. And if you make a non-story game, you can mitigate that by, you know, by putting out alphas and betas for your backers and stuff. With story games, kind of takes out a lot of the fun, you know. And it when the beta stops, it just leaves you wanting more. You can't really replay it and get more value out of it. So. Yeah, you know, the way I see it, I mean, I've been a fan of Kickstarter and I've been following it since 2012, I think. Didn't start backing until later. But it's the rule seems to be that you're always at least video games are always at least 1 year late. We're trying not to be 1 year late, really. But man, when I think about how much work we have done in 1 year, and it's a testament to what it means to work on something that you love and something that you are making because you want to make. Because I've never worked so, I mean, this is the most work that I've done in this kind of period of time ever. It's crazy. And it just leaves me wanting more. It doesn't mean that it's not tiresome, because it is super tiresome. It's tiring, it's exhausting. But I haven't burned out yet, and neither has Tommy or Nico. We just love coming to work and working on the game. Yeah, I got carried away. Well, I'm just gonna, no, I'm not gonna draw anymore, because I have to leave in like 10 minutes. Gonna go ask nicely of Mr. Police Officer not to give me a ticket, because if it really is $150 like the cop said, I'm gonna have a heart attack on the spot. So again, yeah, didn't make too much progress, but well, we did work a bit on it, so let me just save this SP bell. What date is it today? 21st 2017 BSD. Always add the date to your BS, to your version. I mean, I guess it saves it in the metadata or whatever, but it's best to just see it right there in the title. Gonna get rough with it. You'll never get me alive, coppers. Yeah, this has been like one of those. What do they call those on Twitch? The new category, the real life or whatever. Like when people just turn their webcam on and just talk shit. That's what you got today, boys and girls. Now live bot example for you. Thank you, Zarnot. I don't know how do I pronounce that? Is it Zarnot or is it French like Zarnot? Yeah, IRL, exactly. This was my foray into IRL. Let's hope not. Let us hope not. Nah, it's again. Just wish me luck, I guess. And I will hang out for another 3 or 4 or 5 minutes and then go and work some more from home. Gonna work on this other one. This other one here. This one. I don't know if you guys remember the character stream that I did. There was this lady here. Remember her? So yeah, I actually was looking to design a teenage girl character, and this is again not her. This is not her final design, but it's going to evolve into a character that's going to be in the game, and she's going to be hanging out in this work in progress environment here. I am in love with this color scheme. Just love it. Yes, je don't. Okay, Zarnot. Yeah, probably gonna do. I think I'm gonna do another one on Thursday. I don't think I'll do one tomorrow because I'm not really doing one the second. Oh my god. My English is leaving my body. English is leaving my body. I'm not correct way through the mouth. So I'm gonna do another stream Thursday. Probably again around 2:30 p.m. CET. And if I have the time to follow the nice instructions and set up that bot, y'all are gonna get announced via Discord too. If not, I will just post that myself. So yes, and I will park illegally on purpose right next to the cops. No, I will not. I will definitely not. So, my dudes, in 10 minutes I have to go see some cops about some shady dealings. I have to deal with the law, with the man. So, wish me luck. Did a little bit of work. Not too much. Showed you what I worked on last night. I'm gonna show you what I've worked on this morning real quick. See, it's a big ass background, and I have this nice viewfinder here, and I can just move it around, and you can see, like, this is gonna be scrolling all throughout, you know. There we go. It's a big one. You can tell this is the area that's pretty much done. Gonna get some nice dynamic light up in here, and this is very much a work in progress. And there's also this area here, which is also very much a work in progress. Big ass background there. A lot of work. Worked on this one during the weekend too, but it's fun, and I am happy that this is my job. Really happy. So with that, my friends, I bid you adieu. This is actually the house that I bought from with Kickstarter money. Hey Radu, well, you just joined us right when I was ending the stream, unfortunately, but Thursday I will be back, same time, probably, same place, definitely, so 2:30 p.m. CET, that's 3:30 Romanian time. Stay safe, y'all, and Thursday I will update you on the status of my parking ticket. Thank you, that's my house. I just bought it with the Kickstarter money. I just wanted to put that out there. Thanks for contributing. Peace and Lovecraft, and I will see you guys Thursday. No, I will see you guys before on... Oh, wait, I will spam that link again. Share, copy. Discord link, bam. And I'll see you guys on Discord and on stream on Thursday afterwards. Bye-bye, peace out.